Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you a picturesque village in Iran. So stay tuned. Abiyane is a village located on the slopes of the Karkas mountain, lies 38 kilometers away from Natanz city in Isfahan province and is one of the highest inhabited locales in Iran. The altitude of this village is 2,160 meters above the sea level and it has cold and mild weather. Abiyane is one of the renowned villages of Iran due to its indigenous architecture and diverse historical buildings. In the native language, Abiyane is called Viuna, signifying a place replete with willow trees. Historians estimate the antiquity of this village to be around 4,500 years based on remnants from ancient buildings. Considering that one of the oldest human settlements on the periphery of Iran's Kavir Desert. The historical monuments in Abiyane belong to the Sassanid, Seljuk, Safavid and Qajar periods. According to the 2015 census by the Statistics Center of Iran, Abiyane had a population of 147 households, which shows a decreasing rate in comparison to the 1981 census that approximated the number of houses in Abiyane at 500 units. Abiyane dialect is recognized as one of the central dialects of Iran, differing in vocabulary when compared to a standard Persian language. This village was registered as one of the national landmarks of Iran in 1975. Due to the mountainous terrain and the remoteness from densely populated cities and highways, the inhabitants of Abiyane have experienced centuries of isolation. Consequently, they have preserved their ethnic customs, ancient dialect, and traditional attire. Men wear loose and long pants sewn from black fabric, while women don white floral head veils and long shirts made of colorful cloth. The oldest historical building of Abiyane is the Fire Temple, which is located on the slope like other buildings of the village, serving as an exemplar of Zoroastrian temples in mountainous communities. Additionally, Abiyane has several castles that are situated in its southwest and were constructed about 200 years ago, erected by the residents as protective fortifications against local rebellions. Most of the villagers are engaged in agriculture, gardening, and animal husbandry, employing traditional methods. Ranchers built stables 1 kilometer away from the village to house their livestock. In this area, 7 aqueducts are utilized for irrigating fields and gardens. The main products of this region include wheat, barley, potato, and an array of desiccated fruits such as apple, plum, pear, apricot, almond, and walnut. Some of these products, along with other items like native clothes and rosewater, are offered to visitors as indigenous souvenirs. At first glance, Abione appears as a multi-tiered village. Since there was not enough space on the steep slopes to build all houses next to each other, this village was built in the form of ascending floors in the direction of mountain slope and facing upwards, in such a way that the roof of one house is nearly level with the yard of the next house, creating a unique architectural layout. The rooms feature sash-like windows, often have wooden ceilings and balconies overlooking the narrow alleys. The exteriors of the houses are adorned with red soil that common bricks are frequently utilized in their construction. Abione's labyrinthine alleys and narrow covered passages are paved with cobblestones and have short steps. In some parts, there are unique lattice-like structures that work as a natural ventilation to pass the air circulation and make the inside of the building cooler during summer season. In other parts, there are cave-like structures that serve as cisterns to provide potable water for villagers. This village has two shrines and a mosque. These sacred places have doors with intricate geometric designs that are adorned with Quran verses. Other old doors have the same patterns carved on them. Residential houses, on the other hand, showcase doors made of walnut wood with ring door knockers crafted from brass metal, often featuring star-shaped metal decorations. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section, and if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.